desert. Rellekka. Hello everyone and welcome to episode 2 of the Area Bound Ironman. In this episode, I'm going to be doing Fremenic Isles, and before I could do the quest, I had to get the agility level requirement because, you know, in the last episode, I got the construction level requirement, so I needed 40 agility, and at first I was trying to do this course, the Alcarid one, but it's really fucking slow, so I went and hopped over to the agility pyramid and made a little bit money while I got my 40 agility. It took me about an hour to get there from like level 35. So it wasn't too bad. So I came back and hopped back in where I left off on Fremenic Isles and repaired the bridge here. And apparently these people know how to build bridges but do not know how to repair them. So that's where I came in. So I fixed that shit and he gave me some money. Give me your money, bitch. You should also give me some money. I'm already a millionaire at this point, but give me your fucking money too. Excuse me, sir. There's a pubic hair tax and yours is much too long. You're gonna have to give me some financials here. Alright, thank you. Alright, Chef Boyardee, don't think you got through the pubic hair tax. I see the little shit stash on your dick. Yeah, you better hand over that fucking cash. Hey, excuse me, sir, do you like to participate in a new game show? It's called Give Me Your Fucking Money! The pubic hair tax really hit the city hard. I'm glad I could clean up business here, maybe people will get a raise or something. Alright, King, you can just refer to me now as Pimp Daddy Desert. Look at all this fucking loot I got from your hoes. Yeah, I'm a pretty good pimp. In all reality, I only did this quest for the Jester outfit. I don't know anybody who does that any differently, because I don't really need this city for the resources or, you know, the great materials that it has in place. I'd rather just have the Jester outfit. Because look, and also in this cutscene, I can do the Dougie, so that's also really important to this account.
We've been training for decades. It's time to finally show the trolls who the real champions are. When they say, yeah, tis ho, I say, nay, tis it not.
Oh, I'm just fucking kidding. You guys go kill them bitches. I'm gonna go get this free food and luxury spa treatment over here. You guys go, though. Yeah, basically all the warriors died while I was taking that mud bath, but it was worth the risk. So time to go kill the ice troll king. Killed him in one hit. Easy money there. There we go, guys. Well, done with this quest, basically. Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot before the end of the quest, you go and you get a little blowjob, and then you just rip off his fucking head. It's really romantic kind of thing. It's something really popular, and it's not. Alright, and then I got a quest experience reward, and I put it all in HP, and then got the helm of Neatsnot. So it was time to sell the Berserker helm that I completely wasted 30k on, because the sellback value is around 41k. So that was pretty great. The sandwich lady is the only person who came to my 30 construction party. I was a little disappointed, guys, but here's 30 construction. And then I went and sold my pyramid top things to that dude who gives 2,500 GP each for them. And I was able to buy the house and Rellekka for a pretty nice Rellekka teleport. And this will be the last time I do anything in Sears Village. So bye, Sears Village. Right here, I sold that Berserker helm back for 41k. Biggest fucking waste of money ever. I grabbed a bunch of stuff out of my bank and went to go sell it at its respected shops. And we'll see how much I make after I sell it all. I ended up with 29k cash. Not too shabby. Also, I forgot to mention before, I took some of my melee gear and I started killing the ice troll runs. And I got myself a granite shield. So I got both a rune kite shield now, which has better melee defense bonuses, and then I have a granite shield, which has better range defense bonuses, so I'll be using those respectively, whichever Dagonoth king I kill. Yo, Big Mo, hit me up with an easy clue. Oh, you must have misheard me, I said an easy one. Well, fuck you too, and have a nice day. I started collecting snape grass for prayer potions over at Waterbirth Island, and then I would bank them at Exeteria rather than the other two banks that I have access to. I don't have access to Pier the Seer. I can't deposit items with them because that requires me to do the easy diaries, and I can't do the easy diaries because that requires me to go up to the troll stronghold, which is out of my bounds, so I won't even be able to do the easy diaries for this section, so that kind of sucks. I can fill up my empty vials here at the geyser, but I also figured out that Sigmund the Merchant sells water vial packs now, like the water fill vial packs, so I'll no longer be needing to worry about buying vials or anything like that. I didn't figure this out until after I made all these potions, of course, and I made around 140 prayer potions after I decanted them all, and it got me up to 46 herblore. Here's me decanting all my potions and doing a quick price check of how much all my potions are worth. Alright guys, we're going to wrap this video up with me buying iron ore into Tizo. There's a reason why I'm doing it, obviously to make iron bars, but I'll be showing you guys in the next episode why exactly I'm doing all this. And why am I in a PvP world might be a good question, and that's because currently there's... Tizo is literally bought-tizo. Every single area, every single resource you can use in this area is being botted, along with the ice trolls. In the next episode, I'll be showing, like, just a speed run, not speed run, just a speed through of me going through about 50 worlds, maybe 30 to 50 worlds. I've done it multiple times, where there's been bots in every world, and sometimes there's two bots in each world. It's pretty freaking bad, and we kind of need to get on it. The reason why it's bad for bots here is because the shop isn't split for Iron Men, so they can buy out all of my iron ore and before I can get it, and then they're going to just go sell it for profit. The iron ore, like, comes in really fast, like, one comes in every, like, couple game ticks, like, no time at all. So, I just end up hopping in between the two PvP worlds just to get it all. Anyways, guys, thanks a lot for 2,500 subscribers. I just got that today. That's pretty crazy. I mean, I don't have anything else to really say about that. It's just another goal on my channel, and maybe we'll hit 5,000 by the end of the year. I'm also starting to work on a new series. And I'm going to have the NMZ video out later this week. It's just been a little bit of delay with IRLscape being so busy. And I'm also not sure what I was thinking about, what else I was doing. So yeah, that's going to be the end of the video, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll try and do these on weekly uploads. And episode 3, I almost have enough video to come out with, so maybe it'll be earlier than that. Anyways, have a nice summer, guys. Bye. Oh, and also for anybody that's coming home from college, if you lived in a dorm and you had towels separate from when you lived at home, instead of throwing away those nasty-ass towels, keep them around. They're used for many things. Me, for one, I use one as a cum rag because, you know, that shit is just disgusting. There's no other use for it. So, you know, turn your old-ass towel into a cum rag. That's all I have to say. Bye.